If you've ever had to analyze large amounts of data, like real estate figures, your stock portfolio, or other types of information, you've probably wanted to filter things out to get some very specific information displayed. If you're not sure how to do this in Excel, over the next few minutes, I'll show you how to do this using filters. I downloaded this real estate sales data off the web, and it includes some transactions from Sacramento, California. It's not really important what this data is, it's more important on the process on filtering data out. So up on your data tab in Microsoft Excel, look for a command called filter. Now, if you put your cursor anywhere in your table, generally it will find the very top row for you and add the filter automatically. But to guarantee this works every time, you can just always highlight the columns that you want to add your filter to and then click the filter button. And notice how it adds a little drop-down list to all of your different columns. Now you can filter things out based on a specified value. For example, let's find all the two-bedroom condos in Sacramento, California. Go to the city, deselect everything except select Sacramento. Then go to your, say, type residential, condo, multifamily, and only select condo. And there you have it. That's all the real estate transactions for three bedroom, two bedroom, one bedroom, even zero bedroom. Obviously, somebody made a key in error when they entered this data in, but that's not the point here. We can filter this one step further to find only, say, two bedroom condos in Sacramento, California. There's a listing price and the actual size itself. If you want to say, show me all the bedrooms, all the baths, but I really want to find a large place, maybe around 1200 square feet or so. You can go to your square foot, go to your sort by largest, filter by numbers, and go say greater than, say 1200. Click OK, and it shows you just that range of data. You can go one step further and say, show me everything between 1200 and 1400. And just enter the year between 1200 and 1400. And it will show you just these particular listings. They happen to be two bedroom, two bath condo in Sacramento, California. You can also clear if you want, clear the filters for the city, or you can just reselect everything to get all of your data back. You can do this with virtually any amount of data in Microsoft Excel. The only caveat is just to make sure that you don't have any blank rows in your data table. To do that, just visually look at all of your rows and make sure you don't have any blank rows. Generally, filtering goes up to the very first blank row and stops. So if you want to get everything, make sure you have all of your data in all of your rows. That's it. That's how to use filters in Microsoft Excel. If you want to do this automatically, check out my tutorial on pivot tables. Thanks for watching.